Yep.
There it is. This is the kiosk at Cranberry Pond. Jen. The hill down from up where the Mount Toby Ranger Station is. And that is Cranberry Pond. There's a couple of people kayaking. We're down near the other end, probably can't see them. But yeah, we're going to be going that way, following the Robert Frost towards Wendell State Forest. Route 63. The trail runs right alongside this for a little ways. One of the least fun aspects of hiking in Massachusetts is there's a lot of road walking on a lot of the trails, except maybe the AT. Certainly on the old Metacomet, which had to be rerouted, so a lot of it now runs on the road. There's the entrance. The old Robert Frost Trail. On the way to Wendell State Forest, which is 6.7 miles today, so I probably won't get there today. But North Leverett Road's only 1.5, so probably not a problem. And there's the green gloom. Right off the bat, up and up she goes. Literally, this is a long climb to start off of Stafford Hill. Yep, trail's going up that way. Orange place, that's the way we came. This place is a great deal rockier than most of the places we hike. Great many more of these outcrops. And in sections, the trail itself reminds me of Rocksylvania. So, still climbing. I think we're near the summit of Stafford Hill now. About 6-7 tenths of a mile in. And it's not as high as Toby. But the climb is every bit as rugged and often as steep, and it winds a lot. So, yep, as can be seen, I'm using my Kelty pack. And good thing it's not humid. Dew point is low. But it's hot, and that sun is quite brutal. Taking a break up here, as you can see, the hilltop is covered with blueberry bushes. And Jen's down there just below the crest, picking away. It is just covered with them. I'm not sure what hill this is. Taking a break here, pack down. There she is, the Kelty Super Tioga. The little pouch there is actually a microfiber towel, which is awesome. Nice adjustable frame. It's got a little U-shaped piece of metal that allows it to hold open the bag but collapses down easily enough. As you can see, I have the water bladder in that pouch. Not ideal, so I probably will be adding a sleeve on the inside with a port. These packs were made before water bladders were a thing. Through the outer pockets, behind each pocket is a space where you can put water bottles or anything else. Very nice and comfortable pack, and has been very comfortable today. Ranger beads down there. Currently, ...1.06 miles, 2,830 steps. Isn't that nice? Nice sun-dappled day out here. Yep, and raggedy old me. Laters. Serious change in forest now that we're down off Stafford Hill. Had about an hour and a half break as Jen picked all the blueberries clean. So now we're continuing down to North Leverett Road, at which point we'll turn around and have to climb back up these beasts. So yeah, laters. Tricky bit of route here. We don't usually get pieces quite that tricky where Jen just went. All over these rocks here. You would kind of expect it to go down that way, but instead, that way. And up there is where we came from. So yeah, laters. North Leverett Road. Here we are. The sign on this side. Now, on the other side, it said 1.6 miles to get here. So either the sign is wrong, or my odometer is wrong. But my odometer has given me accurate readings for every other place, except this one, where according to this thing, we have gone 1.97 miles. We had about an hour and a half stop up at the top. I'm not sure where the actual trail re-enters the forest, probably down that way somewhere. Need to rest the legs. Laters. So here we are. This is the road down to Cranberry Pond. We were just the recipients of trail magic. A fellow hiking enthusiast picked us up on North Leverett Road and gave us a lift back down here. So just down this road to Cranberry Pond and the car. Trail magic, yay! Laters.